الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters, we spoke in the last week and the week before that about the topic of the importance of considering the acceptance of your good deed, being worried about the good deed being accepted, and what are the signs of a good deed being accepted. Then we spoke after that about the conditions of the acceptance of the good deed, and although acceptance is a hidden thing, is something from the matter of the ghaib, the unseen, then there are signs that show that a good deed you have done has been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, a related topic to that is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He put in the universe. Is a law, a universal law that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put and instilled within this universe, and that is the sunnah of the law of increase, the law of increase, az-ziyadah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases the people in terms of what they are doing. If they are doing good deeds, intend to do good deeds, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps them and assists them to do more good deeds and to make them want to do more good deeds and so on. And the opposite is true also. Those who do evil deeds and strive to do it, intend and aim to do it, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase them in that way that they have chosen for themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَزِيدُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا هُدًى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases those who got guided. He increases them in guidance. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ. Those who got guided, those who chose guidance, then Allah increases them in guidance and grants them their piety. So anyone who treads a path of knowledge, a path towards faith and iman, a path of action, doing good deeds, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases it for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitates and makes it easy for him to do. And then from his bounty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants him even more other things that that person was not expecting to earn or achieve. Those young people who are mentioned in the story of the cave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. There are a group of youngsters who believed in their Lord, وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدًى, and we increased them in guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned those who rely upon Him. Reliance, التوكل على الله عز وجل, it is to rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to depend upon Him completely in achieving what is good for you, in repelling and pushing away what is harmful from you, along with acting upon the means and measures that will bring the result. This is a tawakkul. So you take the means and the measures, but you depend only upon Allah, not on those causes, not on those means and measures. You depend upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring the fruit, to bring something good towards you, or to push away something that is harmful from you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the companions رضي الله عنهم الذين قال لهم الناس, those whom the people said to them, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ. Surely the people have gathered together, they gathered up against you, so fear them. Allah said فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا, so that actually increased them in faith. وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, and they said sufficient is Allah for us, and He is the best of a trustee. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ, they turn back with a bounty and excellence from their Lord. In the battle of Al-Ahzab, the different groups, different armies from the mushrikeen, from the different types of mushrikeen, from the polytheists, they gathered up again, they gathered together against the Muslims. And when the true believers, they have seen this gathering, all of those different types of armies of disbelievers, they said, those who believed, هَذَا مَا عَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, this is what Allah and His Messenger have promised us. وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, Allah and His Messenger told the truth. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا, it has not increased them nothing but in faith, believing and submitting and surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the truce of Al-Hudaybiyah, the truce of Al-Hudaybiyah, which had conditions that the disbelievers put that may be viewed superficially, they are viewed to be humiliating to the believers. Something like, if someone accepts faith from the people of Mecca, becomes a Muslim and comes to the Muslims, then Rasulullah has to turn him back. While if someone disbelieves from the believers, and that didn't happen, alhamdulillah, and chooses to go back to the people of Mecca and disbelieves, then the Rasulullah will not mind it. This is like one of the conditions, and there were other conditions. Superficially, outwardly, they look like humiliating, to a point that some of the companions, they said, why should we give them the low position? This is how it seemed. But then they knew that that was then a commandment from Allah, because Rasulullah kept saying, I am the messenger of Allah and I will not disobey him. This was a commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this treaty or this truce or this condition, these conditions. So the believers knew that they submitted to the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about that, هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين, He is the one who sent down peace and tranquility upon the believers. ليزدادوا إيمانا على قلوب المؤمنين, ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم. So that they will increase in faith along with the faith that is that they already have. So those are examples of the positions of the people of Iman and how they handled those situations when they were cornered in these critical positions. They choose to be guided, they choose to follow guidance, they choose to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only increases them in faith, in Iman, and in guidance subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in those times when we see the Muslims being weakened, the Muslims being attacked from all kinds of corners and by all kinds of different people, this should not lead the believer to be shaken up about his faith and about his being firm upon Islam. Rather, this should increase us only to hold on more to our faith, to our Islam, and to become more certain of it. And if we do that, then we will be increased in our faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us firm on the path of al-Iman, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us, other than guidance and being firm, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us and make us achieve things that we were not even thinking that we would be able to achieve on our own. Along this universal, or under this universal law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He put in the universe, the fact that if you choose guidance, Allah will increase you in guidance. This law of increase, if you choose this belief and you go on with it, you continue to choose it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only lead you into that path that was chosen by you, walayadhu billah. So then, under this is the issue of the good deeds, which we were talking about. This is now for the third week. The one who intends to do a good deed, the one who has the will to do a good deed, من عزم على العمل الصالح, and he was striving hard to actualize it, he was striving hard to have it executed, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assist him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من كان يريد حرف الآخرة يزد له في حرفه. Surah Ash-Shura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the one who wants the tilth, the one who wants the harvest, and the fruits, the outcome, the results, the consequences of the hereafter, you intend the hereafter by doing good deeds, righteous deeds, نزد له في حرثه. We will increase for him his tilth. We will increase for him his harvest, these crops and fruits. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase them for you. And as you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards with one good deed 10 times, up to 700 times, up to more than that, from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in Surah Ash-Shura, just after that with few verses, وَمَنْ يَقْتَرِفْ حَسَنَةً نَزِدْ لَهُ فِيهَا حُسْنًا. The one who performs a good deed, then we increase it for him in beauty. We increase it for him in beauty. We make him more comfortable with it, more peaceful when he does it. And he even wants to do it more. This is why you see the righteous people, they are doing good deeds and pushing themselves to do these good deeds, going through some labor. You think they are maybe, you know, going through difficult times. While they, maybe in the beginning, they are going through that until they get accustomed, then they cannot live without it. This is why the people who frequent the masajid, if they are cut off from the masajid, they feel something wrong in their life until they get back this same thing that they used to do, the peace that they used to get, and well the other good deeds of dhikrullah, of recitation of the Quran and all the prayers and so on so forth. This requires, however, from on our part, requires from us to strive hard. You strive hard for some time, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes you enjoy what you are doing, and actually you will not find peace and tranquility, you will not find enjoyment except if you do those good deeds that you have gotten accustomed to. On the other side of the scale, on the other hand, the sunnah of increase for those who choose disbelievers, you look at the disbelievers and you look at the hypocrites and munafiqun, you will find that they increase over time, walayadu billah, they increase in evil more than the evil that they used to commit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns them that they should not think that the fact that Allah gives them respite, give them more time to live and more time to do things. Let them not think that we are giving them more time, more ability to do evil things. Let them not think that this is better for them. Rather, it is worse for them. They are only being gradually taken to their final destruction while we are the money. So this is the case, and Allah says we only give them more chance, more time, so that they will be increased. They will be increased in sin, and they will have a humiliating kind of punishment. They will continue to do this until they will end up in what is called amal basira, the blindness. There is the blindness of the eyesight. Amal al-basira, someone whose eyes have a problem and then they cannot see anymore. There is something that is even worse than that, and it is called blindness also. And there is the blindness of the insight. The blindness of the insight, meaning the intellect becomes so much corrupt and so much twisted that they do not see things the way they are. The truth becomes falsehood and the falsehood becomes truth all over the earth, and this is because of them choosing what they have chosen. And يَذَرُهُمْ فِي طُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ, as in the Quran, we leave them, or يَذَرُهُمْ, we leave them, Allah leaves them in their transgression, He leaves them in blindness. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned that those who do evil, those who do not believe in the next life, in الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ, believing in the next life is a big matter that differentiates between believers and disbelievers. Because the disbelievers, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا لَا يَرْجُونَ حِسَابًا, they never expected, they never wish or think that there will be some sort of reckoning or accountability. That's why they do what they do without even thinking or caring about what they do or what the evil consequences of what they're doing are. So they will do this, and they will do this, and they will love to do it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَيَذِ بِاللَّهِ زَيَّنَّا لَهُمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ, we beautified for them their deeds, وَلَيَذِ بِاللَّهِ. This is again as a punishment for them for choosing and selecting to do evil and choosing and selecting to continue upon that path of evil, to a point that the same verses that came down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His words, His speech, the result of those words is like completely opposite between the believers and the disbelievers. The same verses that come down, that increase the believers in belief and makes them comfortable and at peace and having tranquility, those are the same verses that will cause the disbelievers and the hypocrites to become even worse. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, زادتهم رجسا الى رجسهم وماتوا وهم كافرون. It will increase them, those verses, the words of Allah, they increase them evil, they increase them filth, to the filth that they already have. And they burn the pathway while they are disbelievers. The same thing, the Sharia, the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah has legislated, those different rulings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated in the Quran and in the Sunnah. The Islamic law that He has given the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the last and the final messenger, the same thing. You find the believers become more humble, become more at peace when the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned, when the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is applied, they become happier and happier, they rejoice. The opposite happens to the disbelievers and the hypocrites, walayyadhu billah, to a point that they are not only disbelievers, but they go even more, they are increased in evil. The same law of increase as the other. They not only disbelieve, but they turn away others from believing in Islam. And this is now a step further in misguidance than just being a disbeliever or an unbeliever by his or her own self. They move one step ahead in evil, walayyadhu billah, and they start turning away others, yasudduna an sabilillah. They turn away others from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same thing will be in the next life. This is what happens in this worldly life. But then the same will happen in the next life. They will be increased. The believers will be increased in their reward in the next life as they are increasing here. And the disbelievers, they will be increased in punishment as they have increased in terms of doing evil in this worldly life. This is why you find that the hypocrites, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about them that they are fi al-darki al-asfal min al-nar, that they are in the lowest rank, the lowest degree of the fire. That's because they were disbelievers plus even more. Disbelievers and deceivers. Disbelievers and more. That's why they are in the worst and the lowest level of the fire. نعوذ بالله من ذلك. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, قيوم السماوات والأرضين, مدبر الخلائق أجمعين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم, وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد, dear brothers and sisters, from the benefits behind knowing this law, the law of increase that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put and instilled in this universe, from the benefits of knowing it is that we do the deed and then we hope that we will be increased even more. This way your day will become better than yesterday. And we hope that even tomorrow will be better than today by doing good deeds and not increasing more of doing the good deeds. Also, the believer will be cautioned against looking down upon the sins and disobediences, and be cautioned against not repenting from falling into sins and disobediences. The ones who are falling into this, they need to be afraid that the next thing could be worse, could be a punishment for this deviation, by deviating even more, turning from smoking cigarettes, into smoking something that is worse, into consuming something that is even worse, into being already blind, far away from the truth, watching things that are evil, listening to things that are evil, then moving on, walayhi billah, to speaking about them with others, then moving on, walayhi billah, to connecting with others in haram and illicit relationship, and then falling into these illicit relationships, haram relationships, and then worse and worse and worse. The law of increase is there. So when we fall into something that is wrong, we need to hold back, we need to be afraid that it might get worse. Next, because Allah punishes for those things. If you do a good deed, Allah increases you in good. If you do evil, Allah increases you in evil, and then you need to repent, to stop this law that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in this universe, to stop it from working in your case. How you stop it? By following what Allah says. If you fall into a sin, you repent and you hold back. And you do good deeds to wash it away and to erase it. As Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اتق الله حيثما كنت. Fear Allah wherever you are. وأتبر السيئة الحسنة تمحها. Follow up an evil deed with a good one, you will erase it. And خالق الناس بخلق حسن. Finally, the hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, which is a hadith Qudsi, which shows how greatly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciates the good deeds that we do, and how He wishes to reward the believers for the good deeds that they do, as narrated by Shaykhan Bukhari and Muslim, that إِذَا تَقَرَّرَ الْعَبْدُ إِلَيَّ شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا وَإِذَا تَقَرَّرَ مِنْهُ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ بَيْعًا وَإِذَا أَتَانِي مَشْيًا أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلَةً. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here in this hadith Qudsi that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrates for us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is other than the Quran. If my servant gets closer to me one hand span, I will get closer to him an arm's span. And if he gets closer to me an arm's span, then I will get closer to him even more than that. And if he gets to me or comes to me walking, I will come to him running. If he comes to me walking, I will come to him running. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives swift and immediate reward for those movements that we have in our hearts, the movements that we have by our hands, and the movements that we have by our body parts that are ibadah, that are acts of worship that are pleasing to Allah. The more we do of this, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings us closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the companions knew the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives for the dua, then they said, even nukthir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful. He grants so much. Those who ask of Him, He gives them. They said, even nukthir. Then we will do a lot of dua. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, Allah akbar. Allah is more, gives more. They said, we do more dua then. If this is the reward, He said, Allah gives more than. Allah akbar. Allah gives me more than what you ask. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit all of us from what we heard, to make us from the people who listen to a statement and follow the best of it. And we ask Him not to make us from those, walayhi billah, the hypocrites, whom He said about them, as in the Quran, Surah At-Tawbah, كَرِهَ اللَّهُمْ بِعَافَهُمْ فَثَبَّتَهُمْ وَقِيمَ قَعُدُوا مَعَ الْقَاعِدِينَ. Allah disliked that they will come up, that they will rise up, that they will come out and do what they are supposed to do. Allah disliked that. They don't deserve it. فَثَبَّتَهُمْ, He made them stay behind. And it is said, stay with those who are staying behind. وَلَيَذِ بِاللَّهِ اللَّهُمَّ إِنَّا نسألك من خير ما سألك من عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعبادك الصالحون، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك من عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. نسألك اللهم الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا، واهدنا سبل السلام، ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور، وجنبنا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن، وبارك لنا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وقلوبنا وأزواجنا وذرياتنا، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، واجعلنا شاكرين لنعمك مثنين بها عليك قابلين لها وأكملها علينا. اللهم ارحم المستضعفين من المؤمنين، اللهم ارحم المستضعفين من المؤمنين، اللهم ادخلهم مدخل صدق واخرجهم مخرج صدق، واجعلهم من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا. اللهم عليك بالظالمين فإنهم لا يعجزونك، اللهم احصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم احدا. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين، اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين، اللهم من اراد الاسلام والمسلمين بشر فاجعل دائره السوء تدور عليه، اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم، اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم، اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم والاموات، ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. اقم الصلاه.
الله اكبر الله اكبر، اشهد ان لا اله الا الله، اشهد ان محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاه حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاه وقد قامت الصلاه. الله اكبر الله اكبر، لا اله الا الله.